What's up, y'all? We're Blackjack Billy, and you're watching countrymusicrocks.net. It's awesome.
Well, let's jump right in. First off, congratulations on the new record deal.
Tell us a little bit about that, and what's
ahead for 2015 for Blackjack Billy.
New record deal. We signed a deal with David Ross and Reviver Records.
He's so neat.
You like how I threw in David Ross and Reviver Records? No, we're very happy to have just recently signed with Reviver Records. David Ross, we met him early last year when he promoted a show that we played down in Mississippi, and we just hit it off, and he came to us with an opportunity, and we're excited to have taken it. As for 2015, we're starting off this year with a new single. We're going to be pushing the radio here, announcing a release date in the next couple weeks, and be back on the road. New music, new singles, radios, touring, shows. We never stop.
Awesome.
We don't like to be bored.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
So you're in the studio working on a new project. Tell us a little bit about that, and what can fans expect with new Blackjack Billy music?
Jeff has been heading that up.
I'll let
him fill you in on the producer role.
Yeah, we've been doing a lot of writing and recording. We haven't stopped while touring, too, which has been a lot of fun. And I don't know, we got about 6 to 8 new songs. We're going to somehow narrow it down to one and put it out. Show some of the same fun stuff we've been doing, some more serious, heartfelt songs. We're letting everybody know the different sides of us.
Sure. And speaking of new music, over the years, music, as you guys know, it grows, it changes, it evolves, especially country music. As artists, do you guys find it more challenging these days to find that balance, to stay true to yourselves, but also stay in that country, box, if you will?
I think for us, being, we were indie for so long, mm-hmm. just playing music for fans, and if they liked us, they kept up with us. It wasn't hard for us, just because it's the only music we've ever made, and
mm-hmm.
just doing what we like, and blessed enough to that people supported us,
If you're only good at one thing, yeah. you just kind of do it.
People always say, where'd you get your sound? I'm like, that's the only sound we can make.
What came out,
So then your tone and everything is still going to pretty much stay the same?
Yeah, that's important to us. I think the fans that we have up to this point like us because that's how we sound and that's the type of music that we make. And it also is important to point out that Jeff is our producer, and so he's intimately involved from the writing all the way through the final product, and that allows to have a continuance of sound that I think will always remain consistent.
Mm-hmm.
At least I hope it does.
And I think we've touring and being together and touring so much the last couple of years, we've evolved quite
sure.
a bit musically.
Yeah.
It's going to have the new stuff is a little different,
mm-hmm.
In a good way, just from naturally, evolving as musicians and touring.
We get to see
band.
If a songs
so, yeah.
work or not live.
Yeah.
Right.
We'll throw them out if they
sure.
stink.
Exactly.
Yeah. Natural evolution is definitely healthy.
We individually will say different things musically, stylistically,
mm-hmm.
and
right.
come out in different songs depending on which one that we're doing.
Nice. Well, that's exciting for you guys. And you guys have such a loyal fan base. I mean, they are,
they
stick with you guys. As artists, what does that mean to you that no matter what's going on with your careers, you guys have a loyal and just a big fan base out there supporting you?
Everything?
Pretty much everything.
Yeah. It means so much more than you could. It's astonishing how much it means to you because it's easy for us to forget when we're not out playing, and then we show up at a show and you see the reaction, you see fans telling you what it means that what we do affects them, how we do affects them in certain ways, and it's really, it gives so much meaning to what we do.
We had a fan that just recently that drove 26 hours
wow.
from up in Canada down to Wisconsin. Wisconsin. And brought us this care package, and
aww.
I mean, it was just, got really emotional with and just told us all this cool stuff about how our music has just really touched her, and just that kind of stuff, just mind blowing. That's awesome. That's why we do it.
And that's got us through a lot of times before, even Nashville knew who we were. Just
mm-hmm.
that having people that were coming out and encouraging us to keep making music.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it's literally our fuel.
Yeah, I bet. No, it's so rewarding. And you guys, just as you were talking about, you're serious road warriors. Last year you were on the road nonstop. Mm-hmm. For folks that haven't seen you in concert yet, how would you best describe your set?
It's about like Hanson meets.
Well, starting off in the bar scene like we did, playing 3 to 4 hour bar gigs, we had to turn it up a little bit in order to get people to pay attention, and that's something that I think has remained consistent till now. We like to throw a party, but I think one of the things we're looking forward to as a band is kind of showing another side of us and playing a one can be a lot in the middle of a set or some more ballad centered things, which we can do now that people are listening a little bit more than they were a few years ago. But a lot of energy, just natural energy. We love to play music, and that comes out on stage. Mm-hmm. And if we're having fun, hopefully the audience is having fun too. Yeah.
If they're going to party, we're going to try to out-party them.
Yeah, right. It's just the free zone there. Yeah. Just let it all out.
Feed off each other. Yeah.
That's great. If given the opportunity, what is one song from any other genre than country would you love to re-record with your own style and put a country twist on it?
Oh, mine would be Bang Bang by Jesse J and Ariana Grande, without a doubt.
She got a booty like...
I want to hear Noll sing Little Janis Joplin.
Yeah.
Yes,
cool.
I love Janis.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Brad?
Take another little piece of mine.
I want to hear him do that.
Honestly, I would love to do like one of those really cool McCartney, Lennon, Beatles songs. You know,
I
just
got
pick one.
Like, I've been bugging these guys to do it, and I'm going to keep bugging them to do it. Bonnie Raitt, man.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
no. I Can't Make You Love Me.
Or Show Pros Run.
I definitely want to do that one.
What do you want me to hear me sing, Jeff? Which one do you want? Right now? You want me to do it right now? Okay, I'll be right.
I love that song. We got to see Bonnie up in
Milwaukee.
Yeah.
Milwaukee. You know.
And that song, just what a well-written song, man. You know, it's just word-for-word melody, everything. And we got to see her and just insane.
Yeah.
What a great question. Now we're going to go spend the rest of the day talking about what songs we want to read.
Right. If you sang that song, that'd be a little too close to our true personal life. So
which one?
I Can't Make You Love Me. He's married. And that's crushed.
We talked about doing that. We talked about it once. And we always try to throw stuff in the set. Wouldn't expect. Like, Rob's done Frozen on stage before.
Let It Go.
Really? We just integrated a little Katy Perry.
We do a Katy Perry thing that Rob sings now.
I gotta say, Rob has a great Katy Perry.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm still working on the outfit.
She's definitely
Ben
better
Ben
looking.
Ben styled it. You need the outfit.
Need to give me a little leotard or something cute to wear.
And speaking of other genres, CMT Crossroads, they do a great job showcasing two genres coming together. Who would you, if you had the opportunity, who would you guys want to be paired up with and why?
Foo Fighters.
Aerosmith.
Aerosmith.
Foo Fighters, Aerosmith. Those would be two great ones.
Yeah.
I've got a big crush on Lana Del Rey right now.
Oh, Lana Del Rey. That'd be a good one.
Yes. That's great.
I'd like stalking.
That would be a crossroads.
That would
be. Love you, Lana. Call me.
Yeah. Let's do it. That'd be a stretch of a crossroads.
She's just so cool.
It'd be killer.
Her vibe.
Awesome. And then music is consistently evolving and growing. In your opinion, what do you think sets country music apart from any other genre?
Fans.
Absolutely. Yeah. We have so many people come up to us and say, my friend brought me, I'm not a big country music fan. Yeah. I had more fun tonight than I've had in a long time. Yeah. And I think it's because the energy that you feel when everybody gets in a room and there's a singular focus on just having a good time, having a couple of drinks, listening to some good music, and that is the essence of what makes country music so much fun.
Boom.
Awesome. And then finally, we're here at CRS. It's a week all about country radio. What is one song that you each remember hearing on the radio that's made a significant impact on your life and still resonates with you today?
That's a tough one. That's a good one.
Really
good question.
Well, doesn't have to be country.
The first one that pops into my mind without it is Just to See You Smile.
Oh, yeah.
Tim McGraw. For whatever reason, I think back through high school and stuff, and I was such a big Tim McGraw fan, and I think that probably opened my eyes to how great country songwriting can be from a storytelling perspective. And his vocal performance is such a simple melody, and being a high school kid who's starting to write songs for the first time, I just loved that song. And still today, we used to cover it, actually, so it's one of my favorites.
When I was moving to Nashville, I was like driving over here and I heard Seen It in Color for the first time.
Yeah.
And I almost turned the car around and went home. I was like, man, I can't do this. What a good song.
Yeah.
You know, I had written some songs in my hometown, had some people that come see me. I heard that and I thought, oh my gosh.
I think for me, the first thing that just popped in my head was The Dance, Garth Brooks. Ooh. Like when I was in the, you know, then younger in the 90s, that's I went, whoa. Mm-hmm. Was that like that's incredible.
I remember running to the piano when I first heard that, going do 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 do
do do do do. I ran to my jaw harp and was like boom. What about you, Jeff?
I'll go with a more recent, but having a kid, you know, first time I heard "It Won't Be Like This for Long."
Oh yeah,
it just melted me when I heard it. So yeah, I love that song.
I thought you were gonna say "You're Gonna Miss This."
That's a good one too.
Trace Atkins kills that
one too.
You're gonna want this back.
That's funny, Craig Campbell just did that in an interview. He picked that song.
And oh really?
Sang it, so that's oh,
he's
Craig.
One of the best in the business. I love Craig.
I heart you. I just did a heart you to Craig Campbell.
We heart you, Craig.
Well, thank you guys so much for catching up. I wish you the best of luck with the new music ahead, and I hope we see
thank
you on the road this summer.
As always, it's good to see you. Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, you as well. Oh, fly like a bullet, fast and free. I'm a rolling stone, come roll with me.